He is a homesick wanderer. He's a multi-talented maestro who taught himself music and film scoring. His life story is an anthem etched in the collective minds of hundreds of millions of people. In July of 1930, 18-year-old Nye Ar boarded a train to escape from the claws of the Kuomintang. Traveling via Hong Kong, he ultimately settled down in Shanghai, an adventurer's paradise filled with money, temptation, power, and celebrities. This was the beginning of a love-hate relationship between a teacher and a student that was of historic significance. At the time, Shanghai was a free trade port where merchants, aristocrats, scholars, and revolutionaries gathered. Even a nobody like Nye Ar dreamed of having a future in the most cosmopolitan city in the East. This nondescript building in Hong Kou District is where Nye Ar lived 80 years ago when he first came to Shanghai. However, the owner said that Nye Ar once lived here, but only for a brief period of time.
Oh,
人住在这里拉拉小提琴，正好拍那个国歌的时候到这里，还到阳台上去。那个时候房子还没这么破，现在越来越破败。哎，没有。Nye Ar knew that the extravagant and indulgent life in Shanghai wasn't the future he wanted, but neither could he see any hope of making his dream come true. What would the future hold for him? The thing that awakened him from his dreamlike state is the violin on display here.
We can see in his old photos some playing the violin. But Nye Ar never had his own violin.
He knew it would be next to impossible to buy a violin with his meager salary, but Shanghai was a land of opportunities. According to Nye Ar's diary, he made a large sum of money by renting films to a movie theater in Kunming. Playing the violin became Nye Ar's only comfort, but his hard work paid off. After losing his first job, the homeless Nye Ar found a new direction in his life.
方明呢，当时他也知道自己的水平，这个指点就是说他拉小提琴呢、啊、都不正规，所以他也觉得没有把握，也是抱着试试看的态度吧，就是这样子。
1931年4月1日，水面果真足够了，你吃过饭，我便准备出发。你到上海好久了？这是他的第一句问话。他给我一个 C 调十六分音符的极高音部练习，因为太花，错的错，落的落，终于没有走完。
Nie Ar formed a group in Yunnan and conducted a few concerts. He was never nervous. He was highly anxious this time because the interviewer was Li Jinhui, the director of the Bright Moonlight Song and Dance Troupe.
Nie Ar 最早就是在中小学、中学的时期就对李景辉的音乐有一定的熟悉，而且他也敬仰李景辉。
After Shanghai opened to the outside world, its politics, economy, and culture flourished under the influence of Western popular culture and music. Li Jinhui was a product of this cultural convergence. Li Jinhui was also known as the father of nursery rhymes. In the 1920s, he wrote such popular songs as The Sparrow and the Boy and Little Bunny. In the 1930s, his troupe boasted such stars as Zhou Xuan, Wang Renmei, and Jin Yan. When the show, The Night of the Bright Moon, debuted, tickets were sold out within an hour. At the time, Li Jinhui was already an accomplished musician. In contrast, Nie Ar was an unemployed amateur music lover looking for a job. But in a sense, only a genius could recognize another genius. It was a classified ad in a newspaper that brought a music industry titan and an inexperienced apprentice together. When they first met, Li Jinhui saw himself in Nie Ar. Nie Ar's experience in teaching himself to play an instrument, his romantic view and unswerving passion for the revolution all reminded Li of his youth. Nie Ar's extroverted personality and Li Jinhui's cultivation made him popular among the troupe. Wang Renyi and Wang Renmei, a brother and sister duo, were often the victims of Nie Ar's pranks. A few years later, the brother became a violin maestro in China and his sister a big star in Shanghai.
经常会发现某些人身上的某个特点，他会很善意的嘲笑他们，把他模仿他们。所以呢，在这以后呢，这个李丽丽、王仁美就给他起了个外号，叫“镊子”。这个镊子就是他老前人的这个镊子。
包括后来金燕、王仁美，他有一大群朋友，我们可以看到很多照片，都是当年。啊，聂耳的朋友写给聂耳的照片写，四个耳朵留存。
Joining the troupe and learning from Li Jinhui was a dream come true. Although Nie Ar was very gifted, he worked harder than anybody else. He also learned to speak Mandarin, which turned out to be very useful for writing songs later. Chen Dan now owns the house where the troupe lived. However, the energetic and mischievous Nia'ar was at the mercy of bloodthirsty mosquitoes.
一九三一年六月三十日，白万字骚扰已到天亮，世纪知识水准两个终点，里面熬杂的打着万字，心里一边下着，明天怎样下法卖一个万扎，不错，明天无论如何要卖一个万扎，打我打万字应付不下的时候，别解决的顶了这个主意，实际上，那什么去卖呢？
嗡嗡，哎，有肥了，老美又打住一个。Nia'ar was too destitute to afford a mosquito net. The only thing that he could sell was a winter jacket.
结果第二天呢，把这衣服打理后，转了这白虎大楼啊，就到这个公司里边呢去看看，这个他当衣服的先生。
还不够买文章的一半都不够，所以啊，就买这么一个文章也买不起。In the end, Nia'ar decided to use the money to go see a movie. Movies and music were Nia'ar's two passions. 嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯嗯
日本侵略中国是在意料中的事，是卡瓦堡上中村失踪等事件不是他的轨迹，现在竟敢大肆侵占东北，大肆起帝国主义暴行，什么飞机场、兵工厂都炸了。
Nia R reportedly took tremendous risk to take pictures of the Japanese invasion of China. He was lucky to get away with it.
日本兵最终没有拿走他的相机，只把胶卷没收了。他把随身带着的新的胶卷重新安进相机以后，顺势呢拍了几个日本军舰。
For a 20-year-old man, this adventure didn't dampen his spirit. Instead, it made him see his future more clearly. Nia R decided to join the Anti-Imperialism Alliance to fight the Japanese with other leftist artists such as Xia Yan, Tian Han. Unlike Nia R, who was a passionate daredevil, Li Jinhui had to face the disillusion of his troop after the Japanese invasion of Shanghai. What was he supposed to do with all the actors, costumes, and props?
1932年3月23日，交涉总算有了结果，服装、乐器、用具为团队所有，公司再给2000为解散费。昨天开会，我没有出席。一决维持团体，共吃甘苦，个人都签了名，我当然遵守。
the Bright Moon Song and Dance Troupe founded by Li Jinhui was dissolved. Funding soon dried up. But under his leadership, everybody stayed together. They reorganized and called themselves the Bright Moon Song and Dance Drama Group. To save money, they rented a supposed haunted house on Changde Road. This building appeared in many of Nia'er's photos when he was a member of the drama group. In order to survive, Li Jinhui created some new songs and dances for the troupe. But with the specter of war looming large, the shows tanked at the box office in Nanjing and Hong Kong. Li was depressed and worried about the future of the group. The musical, Poetry Written on the Banana Leaf, became his last bet. He was counting on it to save the crisis-ridden drama company. When Li Jinhui was dealing with internal and external crises, a review of the musical published in the Shanghai Times by someone named Dark Angel dropped like a bomb on the drama company. Unlike the others, Li Jinhui didn't take it seriously at first. The response was also published in the movie Times. The article was targeted at Li Jinhui, director of the drama group. Who was Dark Angel? Who dared to criticize Li Jinhui and the most prestigious song and dance group in China? Was it a competitor? Although people guessed who it might be, the answer ended up surprising everyone. People talked about loyalty and betrayal, but they couldn't possibly understand how Li Jinhui felt. For his beloved student to criticize him publicly, he felt more disappointed and frustrated than angry and betrayed. The controversial articles and internal ostracization destroyed whatever was left of Nia R's relationship with Li Jinhui. In August 1932, Nia R left the drama company and traveled to Beijing to escape the craziness. A few months after leaving the Bright Moon, Nia R wrote the song of selling newspapers based on the life of a newspaper boy. It was a musical message to Li Jinhui.
Li Jinhui is Chinese's new music, also a very innovative artist. In the original Shanghai, his popular songs opened the Chinese music era.尽管他对聂耳可能有一些不公，但是聂耳在他的音乐创作上得到了很多的一种启发。
In 1954, Li Jinhui wrote in an article, Nia R's criticism wasn't a character assassination. He's a man of great integrity and compassion. Although his words can be harsh and ironic, his intentions are good.It took great courage for him to criticize his mentor. That's why many people in the group respect him, including myself. In times of war, it didn't matter who was right or wrong. What was important was that Li Jinhui's era of vaudeville was coming to an end, and Nia R's era was just beginning.One diary recorded Nia R's life from 1926 to 1935. But some of the pages were missing. Who were they about? What interesting stories did they contain? Join us next time for part 3, The Missing Pages.